Hi guys, CodeTutor here and my name is Anil Deshpande.
Well, in the previous video, we have seen that this particular line of code was causing memory leak. How to avoid this? Now, one simple way of avoiding it is, instead of using this, I can invoke a method called as getApplicationContext. Now, let me try to rerun the application and let me change the orientation. And if you observe, no memory leak is happening now. Even if I change it many number of times, no memory leak is happening. Very interesting, isn't it? Let's have a look at the line which are bone of contention here. The first statement is causing the memory leak and the second statement didn't. What is the difference? In the first case, we have used a activity and in the second case, we have used a context. Now the question is, why can I pass a activity in place of a context? That's because activity is a context. It is a subclass of a context. Well, if they are one and the same, why is the first statement causing the memory leak and the second statement is not? Well, we are asking this question because we have always been under the notion that all contexts are one and the same, aren't they? Well, they are not. Now this leads to a question, where are we getting our context from? Well, you are aware there is a class called as context. This is a superclass. All other contexts in your Android application are basically subclasses of this particular class. And then you have a subclass called as context wrapper. This is the implementation of the context class because context is an abstract class. And after the context wrapper, you have remaining classes like application, service, and context theme wrapper. As you can make out, service is also a context. And the activity that we have been using is actually a subclass of context theme wrapper. It is not directly a subclass of context wrapper. So this makes it very clear that activity and services are actually contexts. Well, what about the broadcast receiver? Broadcast receiver is not a context. However, it gets a context in the onReceive method as one of the argument. This context is not the same context that we are familiar with. It is actually another specialized context called as receiver restricted context. This context doesn't have the implementation of bind service and register receiver because you might be aware that you cannot bind to a service from a broadcast receiver and you cannot register another receiver from a broadcast receiver. However, if you need an application context, you have to invoke getApplicationContext on the context argument that you just received here. And what about the content provider? Well, content provider is not a context. However, if it wants one, it can get one using a method called as getContext. And then you are familiar with the very well-known method called as getApplicationContext. All these three things, whenever they need a context, they get an application context. And this application context is a singleton object. That means in Android application, you have only one object of application. And whenever you invoke getApplicationContext or getContext, you always get the same object. Android doesn't create a new instance of the application context and give it to you. This might give you a clue as to why using a get application context didn't result in memory leak, because you are not getting new instances of the application context. You are getting one and the same. That is why it was not causing the memory leak. But why activity was causing the memory leak? There is something here in the hierarchy of the classes that we are missing as of now. We will have a look at that in the next video.
That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.